Let me put that into perspective. Full load of cargo, fly unrefueled from LA to New York. Ladies and gentlemen, you've put your fingers in your ears, dial down your hearing aids, hang on to your toothpaste, and if you're not, you've already lost them. Holy 10, 20, 30, 40 degrees nose high. Can you believe an aircraft that big and that airplane is over 1/2 of a football field long? That's 174 feet long, nose to tail. It's 170 feet wingtip to wingtip. Basically, you have a giant square maneuvering like that. Can you believe it? That's capable due to the quadruple redundant digital fly-by-wire flight control system. Try to say that 10 times fast. What does all that mean? Ladies and gentlemen, we don't have cables and rods and pulleys in that aircraft like your Cessna. It's coming around. The pilots use the control stick. That's right, a control stick, just like a fighter. Put in an input. Sensors talk to a black box computer. Tells the flight controls to move accordingly, giving an incredible roll rate for such a large aircraft. As the aircraft comes back around show center, it's going to show up for the high-speed banana pass. Why is it called a banana pass? Because it's shaped like a banana. You can't say half moon because, like, do I have to explain it? Set up for a demonstration of slow flight. I have the great opportunity of having California Highway Patrolman Johnson on board. He has his radar gun, and going to read out in miles per hour, how slowly a C-17 comes across show center. Officer Johnson, as the aircraft. Do you have your radar gun, Officer Johnson?
Yes, I do.
As it comes across show center, you'll notice with this wind, I'm guessing the runway, I'm going to guess that it's probably no more than 80 miles an hour ground speed. As you see, it's coming from right to left, literally hanging in the air. How is that possible? Those slotted flaps. Slotted. They are so large, they extend into the engine exhaust. We have what's called power lift. I know, ladies and gentlemen, that sounds like an oxymoron. But the bottom line is, when we throw the gear out and go to full flaps for landing, this aircraft lands like no other one. Power, or the throttles, become pitch, or altitude. The stick becomes airspeed. So right now, Colonel Guillot has that stick about in his lap. It's about 12 degrees nose high as he comes across show center. Johnson, Officer Johnson, what do you read? What do you read, Officer Johnson? 84 miles an hour, 84 miles. How about now, Officer Johnson? 81 miles per hour. I know there are some of you that have driven on IA faster than that. Go to Rochelle. Officer Johnson, I'll get you. The aircraft is obviously demonstrating its agility at both high and low speeds, making it easy to operate in any tactical situation, including the delivery of paratroopers or heavy equipment. I talked about earlier the quadruple redundant digital fly-by-wire. The aircraft has four separate flight control computers. We don't even know if we lose one. If we lose one, we don't know. We lose two, we get a light. We lose three, well, now we're looking for a place to land. We lose four, no problem. I flip four switches and that airplane becomes has the fastest, the biggest, the heaviest, the coolest looking Cessna 172. We put it down on a 3,500 foot long by 90 foot wide gravel strip. Folks, as the crew enters into the turn and scoop, the speed is approximately 150 miles per hour. That mid diameter turn is just over 4,000 feet. How is that comparable? That's like driving an 18 wheeler 85 miles an hour trying to do a 180 degree turn in a 2-lane road. I don't think you can do it. C-17, you can turn on the line. We call this a transformer turn. As it comes across show center, you see the power up. The gear will retract and the slats will track. It'll be setting up for a tactical. Personnel, it can raise one set of landing gear for tire change, each engine gets on board, struts it, and comes back around for a simulated short field landing. We are doing a tactical arrival. Tactical arrival, the concept is stay as high as possible above the threat of small arms fire, maneuvering at 1,500 feet above the ground. I'm going to pick an 8-point, I'm going to guess about halfway down the runway. That's right, folks. You got an 8,000 foot runway, we only need 3,500 feet. You don't pull back on the stick. I don't know if we can hear it based on the winds. It's howling. I know it's howling up here on the announcing stand. I'm going to guess the landing roll will be less than 1,500 feet. The aim point is set. Right at the intersection. Right on mark. Crew is literally standing out of the seat. Standing on the brakes, giving it a full thrust reverse and demonstrating the capability of the aircraft in this world can do. Since I can't tell who's in the left troop door, but how about you put your hands together, give a big wave to one of our